NASDAQ Trade Talks. I'm your host, Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at NASDAQ. We'll be coming to you live from IDX 2018 at the Brewery in London. Joining me for this segment is Larry Thompson, Vice Chairman of the DTCC. We're going to focus on where we are now and where we are headed. I ask myself that a lot, but we're talking specifics and financial markets. Larry, how will disruptive technologies like cloud, like DLT, how's it impacting the landscape you operate now in terms of infrastructure, risk management, cybersecurity?
You know, it's interesting. I actually think that it's having a very positive effect. Disruptive technologies, especially DLT and cloud, and let's focus on cloud computing first, very mature at this point in time in terms of its development. And for the financial industry, it could solve some of the problems that we've been dealing with, such as dealing with cybersecurity. A lot of these cloud computing firms have 6,000-7,000 experts just dealing with cybersecurity issues, something that an average firm would never have the ability to have. Also, they give you the ability to be in multiple locations and to have the kind of resiliency that you simply couldn't have if you had your own proprietary data center. So I think there's a lot to be said for greater efficiencies and cost reductions that'll be had with cloud computing. I think with distributed ledger technology, you know, it's going to be a game changer, but probably in the future. Not right now. It's not really technologically as mature as it should be from a technological standpoint, but I think it will help solve a lot of the problems in areas where we don't have the technology and the ability now to be able to do it. So again, with distributed ledger, I think there's going to be real opportunities, but I think it's going to be down the road.
Well, let's talk about that 12 to 18 months out. How do you feel about cooperation among the regulators from the post-Brexit world? We're still talking about Donald Trump at that point. Do you think it's challenging for regulators with the geopolitical situation we're in right now?
I actually think the regulators now are cooperating more than I've ever seen them before. They're communicating with one another. It's always going to be tough for regulators because in the end, you know, their bosses are the politicians, and they have to deal with that. But I do think they're all trying to work together to solve the problems. They recognize that we're still a very interconnected financial industry, and that cooperation means that the problems that happen in the U.S. could easily follow to Europe, could easily flow to Asia. And so they all have to cooperate and communicate and understand the challenges that they all have.
Well, thank you very much for joining us at IDX. Thank you for joining me throughout the day. I'm Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter.